first scholar, the model was actually proposed by two scholars. The first scholar's name is Claude Shannon, who was a mathematician and he worked for the Bell Telephone Laboratory in 1949. And the second scholar was Warren Beaver, who was an engineer and also a scientist in 1949. Now you see, this model comes exactly a year after when the Laswell model came, right? And remember when we were talking about Harold Laswell, who proposed Laswell model, when we saw his background, he was a political scientist, not a communication expert. And you can notice that neither of these scholars are communication experts. This person is a mathematician who was working for Bell Telephone Laboratory. This person is an engineer, a scientist. He was Warren Beaver was Claude Shannon's co-worker, and they both proposed the model. What I'm trying to say here is, while considering the background of scholars who proposed the model, that people who actually developed the field of communication, they did not belong to the field of communication. Harold Laswell was a political scientist. These two, one of them is mathematician and the other one is a scientist. People who were working in like when the field of communication was developing, especially when the field of electronic media was developing after the invention of telephone and after the invention of radio, there were many things, there were many processes that were happening that scholars thought were important to be studied, important to be explored. And so this was the background for the beginning of communication models. And people who actually worked in this field were initially not from the field of communication. Another thing that you may notice is that, well, communication, first of all, is a field, is a diversified field, and people who actually do not belong to the field of communication, they have proposed significant ideas in this field. In mass communication, many times we discuss ideas of Noam Chomsky. We discuss ideas of Marshall McLuhan. His theories are very important. We also discuss ideas of Edward Said and many other scholars. And none of them was actually a communication scholar. So communication is a field that culls ideas from different areas. It's a diversified field. Alright, so now just pay attention to the year when the model was proposed, 1949. Although TV, they had invented TV, but it wasn't a popular medium. Not many people had it. That was the time period of telephone. Telephone was becoming important. And that was the time period when radio was becoming popular. Radio was invented maybe half a century ago, before this model was proposed. So the two important mediums during this time period were telephone and telephone and radio. Now I'll draw this model on board in front of you so that it makes you can get an initial understanding, and then I'll come back to the slides and explain it more. Like I just said that the model was proposed in 1949, and that was the time when telephone and radio were the most important mediums. So what they did, Shannon and Beaver proposed that actually the process happens in a way, I'm not writing the whole word info, I'll only write information source. There is an information source, and that goes to audience, or you can say destination. Audience or destination. So they said that in order to send information to the destination, we need two more things. We need a transmitter. This is what Shannon and Beaver proposed. They said we need a transmitter, and then we need a receiver. You see, the machines that actually perform the function. Suppose there is information source. Let's say a human being. He is delivering a message. In order to get this message to the destination, Shannon and Beaver people propose that you need a transmitter and a receiver. Now, let's take the example of telephone. I said that the model came in 1949. That was the time when telephone and radio were popular mediums. So, in order for the information to get to the audience, they need transmitter, radio. So, radio, through radio, let's say they want to broadcast an information, they would need a transmitter. And then further to get it to the destination, to audience, they would need a receiver, another device, another machine. So there has to be a machine on both ends, from the sender and from the receiver as well. And then they said, they further proposed, there is another thing that comes in the middle. This can be noise. And we all know that what is noise? Noise is any barrier that affects the flow of information. Sometimes it doesn't have to be technical. Although in this case, I mean, if the transmitter is not working fine, of course they will create noise and it will hinder the flow of information. If receiver is not working fine, it will again hinder the flow of information. But I'm just to help you understand, I want to say that noise is anything that actually hinders the flow of information. So even sometimes thoughts can also be a noise. You are listening to me right now. If any one of you is thinking that, well, lecture, maybe if you have thoughts that are not related to lecture, then it's noise because I'm not able to communicate effectively, or you are not able to understand effectively. That can be noise. If I drag this chair and it creates noise, it kind of hinders your understanding, that is also noise. Like I have said many times, if someone enters the door is squeaky and it kind of creates a trouble or problem for you to hear me properly, that is also noise. But right now, let's just focus to Shannon and Weaver's model. Well, this is how they proposed the model. They said that actually there are two elements for a process of communication. The main element is information source, sender, and the other element is audience. But in order to complete the process, there has to be two more elements. And the both elements were related to technical devices, a transmitter and a receiver. And then they added this as well. They said that this element as well, they said that, but sometimes the flow of information is not smooth if it is interrupted by any kind of noise. Now you see, information goes, it begins from here, it goes to transmitter, then if there is some noise, it passes through there, then it goes to the receiver, which is another device, and then it goes to the destination. In this way, this is another linear model that we are discussing. We already discussed Laswell model, which was linear, and this is the next linear model. Just to repeat, I already explained what a linear model is. Just to repeat, a linear model, linear is, I mean, if we try to understand this term in mathematical sense, linear is something that goes in straight line. And you see, the flow of information is going in the straight line. So yeah, this is linear. Again, the model is simple, but if we just consider the background when the model was proposed, then the whole thing becomes quite easier to understand. I'll stop my lecture here and now we'll go back to the PowerPoint.